Oh, great. And do you have a wireless mouse for me?
Takes place in space and time, and so it's necessary for you to physically be there. But go ahead and let yourself mentally be there. I'd like to share with you an incident of play that happened for me recently. This happened on the shores of Lake Superior, on the north shores of Lake Superior, in Grand Marais, Minnesota. And I like to call it fort building. When presented with this glorious vista of the shores of Lake Superior, I noticed after walking several hours along the shores, it was positively littered with paper birch, driftwood, and lodgepole pines. And this was really fascinating to me. And a companion I was with asked if I'd like to build a fort. So we began gathering the wood. It began as a collaborative process at first. We came together to build the structure, and there was a lot of language actually used in discussing how it was that we wanted to build the structure. We got some rather hefty logs to begin, and so this is the beginning of the structure. But after that first kind of architectural feat was accomplished, we went immediately into the wordless negotiation. Each of us continued to bring material to the site. Some was placed immediately on or on top of the structure. Some of it we set aside. Many people came up to the fort and simply began building along with us. Some of the scrap that we didn't quite know what to do with that we had gathered, one of the participants actually wove into a beautiful lattice and added as panels to the side of the fort, something no one else had thought to do. So she went ahead in that situation and decided to lead. There was a point in this process where it occurred to everyone that we were done. We'd finished. And we really, again, this is the wordless negotiation. No one stirred any longer. We all stood back and looked at our handiwork. And we knew that we were finished. The fort was then left for the lake to take back. To be deconstructed by others, or possibly to be completed, because as you can see, it didn't really have walls. However, you can see some of the beautiful lattice work that one of the participants added. This is one of those lovely panels right here. And this is the back. This is my favorite view. Some things to remember about play. Play may take several hours. This took a few hours, this took some time. Play may happen in an instant. You may be playing right now. It can be that fast. It's not necessary to document play events. Now, I did happen to have a camera, but it's absolutely not necessary. Ignore what frightens you when you're playing. And, you know, this may just generally be good advice. Laugh as frequently as it comes. It's a really effective way of letting other people know how much fun you're having. And when you feel like laughing, just let it out. And anywhere is as good as anywhere else to play. You really don't have to wait for a special time. I've got some suggested tools for play. Receipts, or whatever it happens to be. This can be terrific playthings. Pens. Pens are essentially sticks, of course. Some of them do a wonderful clicking, and most of them make marks. So you can use them in a variety of ways. Tennis, golf, basket, foot, base, or other balls. Any kind of commercially produced ball can be an excellent object around which to center a play event. Try to let go of some of those conventional ways that we interact with these things, however, and you can make up some great new games. Sticks, grass, leaves, dirt, snow, anything really that the earth kind of sheds on us, it's there for us to pick up and play with. Blankets and couch cushions, these are wonderful. If you're ever ill, build yourself a fort. Build it in your living room. Crawl inside, you'll be comforted. However, remember, there are no specialized tools necessary for play. Thank you. Karin.